Hello. So, my name is Michael. I'm from Romania, and about a year ago I started collecting mechanical calculators. This is actually my sixth mechanical calculator. I wanted to include some other mechanical calculators in this video, but I just changed my mind and I figured I would do a video about each one of them. So, what is this thing? This is called a mechanical calculator or a pinwheel calculator, also known as an arithmometer. The arithmometer was invented by a Frenchman named Thomas something, I forgot his name, anyway, it doesn't matter right now. And after that, after his design, which was completely flat, right about this level, a man named Ednar, who lived in Russia, he was actually from Sweden, he moved to Russia in the 1880s or something like that, wanted to improve upon his design, and he came up with an arithmometer that has another design, something like this. This is actually a clone of later Ednar arithmometers, but different companies made different improvements to the design, and here we have Brunsviga, who in the latest model called 13RK or 13RK, as Germans would say, they've included a few interesting features. So, how does this thing work? First off, I need to explain the registers. Any pinwheel calculator will usually have at least one register, but usually three if it's one of the other types. This is called the result register, or the accumulator, or the sum register. Sum as in sum of 1 and 2 equals 3. This is called the turn counter, and these are the entry levers, you know, the input register. What are they used for? Any number you want to work with first has to get entered in the input register, for example the number 123. We select, let's see, oh, also another interesting improvement, notice these little numbers here. This was first an idea of Brunsviga, I think. So anytime you move the levers to enter a number in the input register, you will also see the number show up in the verification register here, or the verification window. So, the number 123, we enter it by selecting 1 here, 2 here, and 3 here. So, the lever selects the number, but we also have the checking register. Not all pinwheel calculators have this. This is a feature which Brunsviga really wanted to have, to make people's life easier, I guess. So we have 123, but what do we do with it? If we want to do an addition, we first have to add it to the sum register. So 0 plus 123, turn the crank once. 0 plus 123 is 123. Okay, what does this mean? What's useful for? Well, now we can enter another number, which, by the way, if we want to clear this lever row, we just use this crank here and it clears it for us. Now, 123, we want to add a number like 59. I said 59, not 69, because I don't like that kind of jokes. So, 59. We just turn the crank and it just adds it to the sum register. Sorry for the cars outside, I live in an apartment complex. So, again, 123 plus 59 equals 182. Simple, right? Now, this is just basic addition. What if you want to multiply a number, let's say a large number, 123 by itself, to do a square number? Well, by the way, this lever clears all of them at once, because Brunsviga decided that an operator wants to quickly ready up the calculator for another calculation, and why should you do this every time when you can just do this? And there we have it. So, 1, 2, 3. Now, what is this for? And also this, by the way. Well, the carriage can move, because you don't want to turn the crank 123 times, right, to square up the number. So you just do first three times for the first digit. Well, let's do it the proper way. So, the number has three digits. We first go to the third digit, which is this one. Also, when I move the carriage, we will also see this get selected. So, moving the carriage to the right, selects number to the left. So, 123 times 1. Now, we shift to the right, basically like this. Turn it 2 times. 1, 2. And finally, we can also use this. So, 1, 2, and 3. So the result of 123 times 123 is 15,129. I can just show you by zooming in. 15,129. And also the number 123 appears in the counter register. Again, I do not own proper filming equipment, because I'm not a YouTuber. I'm just doing this video to exemplify the functionality of the calculators. What about division? Well, division is just repeated subtraction, but how repeated subtraction? You have to count how many times can you subtract a number from another. I'll exemplify. So, let's do, because division can be done in two ways. One is floating decimal point, and the other one is the integral type division with fractions. I'll just do the fractions first. So, if we have, let's say, 15, we enter it in the result register, and we want to divide this by the number 7. Well, I need to clear this register, but I won't pull this lever right away, because if I do, it will clear both the register and this. So, well, actually in division I can do that because I need it, but let me show you. If I didn't want to clear this as well, I would just pull this lever here, and when I pull this, it doesn't clear the input register, but if it's in the second place, it will clear both the counter register and the input register. So now I said I want to divide by 7, so I just set to 7 and start subtracting. So this will show me the number of subtractions. Also, notice that the numbers here are now white, but when you do a negative transfer division, they will become red. So here we are, 1, and 2 and 3, nope. Now what happens when you do an overflow? This is what it's called. When you do an overflow, because machines like this cannot handle negative numbers, it just shows the 10th complement of the number, the negative number, and fills the other numbers with 9. What this means is that here you cannot see it, it's imaginary, but it's a 1. So basically it subtracts the number you just entered from, I don't know, 100 bin or so, and the rest of the numbers are 9. What do you need to do in this case? Well, in traditional polynomial calculators, we do not have a back transfer mechanism, or not a back transfer mechanism, actually a tens transfer. So you would need to do another positive term. So now we have the proper number. I'll explain what that means in a little bit. So the result of dividing 15 by 7 is the number in the count register, which here we can see in red is 2, and the remainder of 1, which is actually in the reserve register. So we write this as a fraction. It's 2 and 1 over 7. I'm not sure how you write it in your country. I've noticed that different countries write integer type fractions by in different ways. But anyway, we just write it by 2 after and afterwards the fraction. So this is how you divide by using remainders for fractions. This is actually a very useful feature, because normal digital calculators nowadays do not show this remainder. And in engineering, it's useful to write numbers as fractions, because that's how you can get the most accurate numbers. So, if I wanted to get the result as a normal calculator nowadays, how would I do it? Well, let's do the same thing again. So, I'll just move the carriage to the right. Also, most people will enter the number starting from the six digit. But you can just enter it from here. The reason why they do that is because you have these little things here, which are reminders for where the decimal point resides. Actually, I'll just do it how they do it, because I want to show you the proper way to put the decimal place. So let's see. If we enter it like this here, so 15, notice that now we have 11 zeros after the original integer. We place this little reminder here. You can place it over the decimal or between them, doesn't really matter. It's a matter of preference, really. So just remember, we have 11. Now we clear both the input and the counter, and we want to divide by 7. So we have a 6 here. So what happens now? We place the reminder here, and we look a little bit at what we just did. So we have a 7 in the input register and 5 zeros after the divisor. What does this have to do with our division? We have to manually decide where the floating decimal point will reside, and we do this by subtracting the number in the input from the number from the initial integer. So we have 11 minus 5, so it's 6. We will have 6 digits after the integral part of the result. Your calculator, digital calculator afterwards, your electronic calculator will do this automatically, and you will never know about it. But this is how it was done in the old days. So now I'm just going to use the tense transfer mechanism to do the division. So like I said, you would usually do negative turns until you hit the bell, and then afterwards you will do a positive turn to return and move the carriage. But I'm using the tense transfer feature, which I'll show you immediately. So how many times can we subtract 7 from 15? Well, let's see. We have 1, and it immediately run because it was 1 here. And now all I have to do is move the carriage and do positive turns until it rings again. And now I move the carriage again and repeat the process. And that's basically it. So the result of dividing 15 by 7 in decimal 14-decimal point style is actually, as you can probably not see very well, 2. Right. I'll just do this. So it's 2.142857. That's what your electronic calculator does. And last but not least, all the levers here. So I've mentioned before about something called the back transfer mechanism. If I didn't, I'll explain immediately what that is. So, again, this lever is for telling the machine whether or not to also clear the input register when I pull this lever for using an immediate division. So I'll just leave it to do that and pull this lever so it clears, it basically pulls the other ones, it clears all of them at once. So let's say we have successive multiplications. We have the number 5,799, and we want to multiply it by 23. So we do this 2 times and 3 times. Now, in traditional pinwheel calculators, you will just have to reset the input register and type in the number manually if you wanted to enter this result here to perform another calculation. But the machines which have a back transfer mechanism can do that automatically after immediately clearing the, input register. It's done like this. So we clear the input register with this lever and we pull it a little bit more, and now we just clear the machine, and as you can see, it automatically set the input register, and now we can perform another calculation. So the result can be again multiplied by something like, I don't know, let's do a simple number. 3. 1, 2, 3. Again, we could just enter this result here for another multiplication, just to show it again. So I'm using the back transfer mechanism, and now I can do another multiplication. This was not actually Brunsviga's idea, but they've improved upon the style of back transfer mechanism, and they wanted to make sure the operator has an easier life using the machine. So there you have it. The functionality of the Brunsviga 13RK. Thank you for watching. I'm not sure if I'll do videos on the other calculators. I intend on it, but I do not have time. However, thanks for watching.